Man, that is super cool. I've got Ray Carlton in the Burger Bunker with me today, and he's brought over this, his latest creation. What do we call it?
TLTC.
It's got a Tasmanian myrtle top, very nicely carved. It's actually a flat top, but it's just beautiful to feel and touch. A mahogany back. Is it one piece?
Yeah.
One piece. One piece super carved mahogany back. Looks quarter sawn to me because the grain's running straight down. We've got some Mick Brierley B90s, which are little rock and roll machines. Are they? Do we know what's the story with the B90s? Is it just his take on the
it's,
B90?
It's a P90 in a humbucker format.
Okay, cool as.
So the pickup, the coil is squashed a bit shorter and a bit wider.
Yeah.
So you've got a big fat single coil.
Righto. And it is big, fat, single coil sound too. This shallow bridge is a beauty too, isn't it? It's a top-loading bridge, so the string's straight through the back, and everything is basically set and forget where the rollers and the string spacing is concerned. It's a really nice, hard chunk of German engineering. The neck is a maple neck with a modern C shape. We've got a 12-inch radius rosewood board. We've got some 6150 medium jumbo frets, expertly finished and polished, because that's what Ray does, a bleached bone nut, and some Goto traditional hardware.
Lockers.
Oh, they're Goto lockings, are they? Wow, even better. The reverse headstock is a really cool touch, and it slightly alters the tension in a good way, I think. The strings are running straight through, so there's nothing grabbing at the nut. And because it's top-loading, it's just a really big ringing machine. So let's have a listen to it. I'm running the Magnatone Twilighter stereo, which I've fallen in love with and I'm using quite a lot lately. The rear pickup, Mick Brierley's B90. Great, isn't it? So it's got that B90 bark, the P90 bark, and still the single coil zing, but it's fat. Neck pickup. Again, lots of definition, and it's not too much wooliness where it's overdriving the amp into that flubbiness. It's great. Middle position. Tons of tones. What have we got under here? 500K CTS. No bleed. Nah. You know, it's the simple things, isn't it? I've got a Wampler Plexi Drive, the brand new one, actually, the little mini Plexi Drive at my feet. Let's turn it on. That's where that pickup really shines, isn't it? It's like a snarling dog with definition. A very nicely washed snarling dog. Wow. Wow. Thank you. Great ad for Brian Wampler's little Plexi Drive too. What a pedal. It's killer. We'll demo that further soon. So this is headed up north to sort of Central Coast, Port Macquarie area, is that right? Lucky is the person who has purchased this guitar, because it weighs, it feels like it weighs about 3K or less. Would that be right?
3.2, I think.
3.2, okay. That's still remarkably light, and it just tings and it doesn't feed back, and we're running at 102 dB in here, which is way too loud. So it's just proven itself in terms of its sonic integrity. It's not going to take off. Is there a chunk of mahogany running down the middle?
Or down to just behind the bridge.
Okay.
It opens up into a chamber behind it.
Righto. So losing even more weight. But it's great. It's a bloody ripper. What model do we call it? TLT?
TCTL.
TCTL.
Clean skin.
TCTL by Ray Carlton at carltoncustomguitars.com.au.
That's the one.
If you want to order one, give Ray a yell. This is going north, and it's a shame because it would be so at home here.
Should be in Melbourne, shouldn't it?
Yeah, it should be in Melbourne. In fact, it should be in Mount Eliza. It's a ripper. Thanks, mate.
Thank you.
I'll just play you out with some more Wampler. Oh, and a little bit of stereo pitch vibrato. That's right, 1973. I haven't left. I never left.